Look, Woodman, I don't care what kind of a witness she is. We got to figure out some way to fight her testimony. Well, you're the lawyer. You tell me. Murder one. No. No. No, Susie is not standing trial. Well, if you can't do anything, I will. I promised Susie she would not stand trial.
What did the lawyer say?
The DA's moving to murder one.
Oh, no.
Susie shot Warren in self-defense. She was protecting her baby.
Yeah, you know that, and I know that. Every sane person knows that, but Wendy is twisting the whole thing around.
But how can she? I mean, the facts won't bear out.
Woodman said that Wendy is a very strong witness.
That doesn't necessarily mean Susie will be indicted.
The grand jury will hear other testimony, too.
Wendy talked to the DA and convinced him that the whole case should go to the grand jury. Now, if she swayed him, what is she going to do with the grand jury?
We're just going to have to wait and see what they decide.
I can't wait. No. I got to talk to Father Tracy.
Father Cadney, it's past 11. Why would you want to call?
I promised Susie that we would be married. That's one promise I can still keep.
I see.
Look, see, if I set the date tonight, we can get our marriage license tomorrow.
Are you sure that is the wisest thing to do, especially now?
Mom, she needs me. Susie needs to know and feel that I'm there.
I realize that, son, but a wedding should be remembered as a happy time. When this is over...
When? When will this be over? We don't know. A week? A month? A year? Do you realize what's going on? Wendy wants Susie to go to prison. She wants to take her baby.
Kate, I have to go to the studio.
At this hour? Can't it wait?
No, I'm afraid it can't. Stephanie asked me to transcribe some tapes and she needs them first thing in the morning.
I'll see you later.
Justine?
Let her go. All this can't be too easy on her.
I'm aware of that. I just don't want her to feel that we're shutting her out.
Mom, I need to get back over to Susie.
Cagney, wait. I see your mind going a mile a minute. Isn't there some way that I can be of help?
What can you do?
Try me.
Listen, I'm going to go make some tea.
Look, I made three promises to Susie. One, she would not stand trial. Two, Susie would never be separated from Jonah. And three, we would be married. I have to keep one of those promises.
As for the trial, now that is out of your control. I understand your desire to protect Susie from that ordeal, but you really can't keep that promise.
Mom.
You can work with her lawyer. If the grand jury hands down an indictment, help Susie make the strongest case possible. As for marriage, you don't want to overwhelm Susie with another major decision at this point. You two love each other, and soon you'll be able to keep your word. You will be married.
I've been waiting for a long time, Mom.
I know. And as for Jonah, no power on earth can separate a mother from her child.
What are you talking about? It happens all the time. One parent will kidnap his kid. Another will get the courts to award custody and then not give visitation rights. It happens all the time. It's very easy for a parent to be separated from a child. What I don't want to do is give Susie some false kind of encouragement, pat her on the back, say it's going to be all right when it won't be. She could lose her son. You of all people should know that.
Cagney.
Mom, I'm sorry.
People.
But I want what's mine.
How can you say that? It's mine. It belongs here.
But I can take better care of it.
I have been taking care of it all along.
That does not change the facts.
Stop arguing, please.
I won't give it up now.
Neither will I. I will never part with it.
It doesn't belong to either of you.
Of course it does. And I can prove that it's mine.
I have legal proof, too.
Stop arguing! We can all be together and share it. The door is open. We can walk through it together.
Liza?
Oh, why, Dee, are you waiting up for me?
Kind of. I guess I fell asleep.
Well, I certainly didn't expect to be out this late. I had a little bit more convincing than I imagined.
How did the dinner go?
Oh, on a scale of 1 to 10?
8.5.
Yeah, that's wonderful.
I haven't won that war yet. I sure fought a terrific battle tonight, though you should have seen me. I was really hot.
Toaster.
Well, maybe a little hotter than that.
No. I had a dream about a toaster. You and Lloyd, you were arguing over a toaster. I don't know, I guess that was funny.
What do you think it meant?
I don't know.
Ah, yes. Dr. Centel. You eat the toast? I see it clearly now. You dream of the toaster.
No, I don't think that was it. Do you remember that toaster that you gave me to bring to the school's fix-it drive? Mm-hmm. Well, I gave it to Ryder instead. Because I thought that he could salvage it and then maybe sell it. Maybe I have a guilty conscience.
Oh, well, sweetheart, I don't mind you giving it to him. In fact, I may have some other things you can give him. But I don't want you down by the docks.
I was careful.
It is a very dangerous place.
I can't give up going there. That's exactly what Lloyd said in the dream. He said I can't give it up.
The toaster?
Yeah. You two were pushing it back and forth between you. And then Lloyd said, it's mine. And you said, no, it's mine. And neither one of you would give it up.
Well, you know, sometimes we see things more clearly in our dreams.
No, I don't understand this one.
Did that pretty toaster have long blonde hair?
Is that what this is about? Where I belong, whether I'm a Kendall or a Centel. I guess that must have been it.
Lashed out at you like that.
That's all right.
Oh, I'm sorry I said that.
Please, no more. Go to Susie.
Mom?
It's late. I'm suddenly very tired. Give my love to Susie.
I will.
Good night, Adair.
Good night, Mom.
Mom, I'm sorry.
Good night.
She'll be okay.
It just came out of my mouth before I could...
Stop dwelling on it. It's over. How about taking off your jacket and having some tea?
I really need to get back to Susie.
Cagney, she's probably still sleeping. Besides, you look like you could do with some refueling. Mm-hmm. Mom's, soda bread and raspberry jam?
Oh, how could I say no,
huh? I thought it would get you.
You know something? Since you came back, we've barely seen each other.
I didn't think you'd notice.
Give me a break.
I know a lot's been going on in your life.
Yeah, but you've kept me in the dark, so what's going on with your life?
Well, if you really want to know...
Mm-hmm.
The Count de Mornay has asked me to marry him. But I've already accepted a diamond as big as the Ritz from the International Playboy. Binky Williams?
You so, wish, you wish.
You don't think I'm up to it.
I think you're up to anything you want to do. But that's not what you want.
Actually, my life lately has read like one of Mom's romance novels.
So you're going to tell me you're about to ride off into the sunset with some guy?
Maybe not that exotic.
Well, don't keep me hanging. What's up?
You really want to know?
Can't get out of it now.
I want you to know. It'll help to get it out.
Mm-hmm.
When I left for California. Alec Kendall was in love with me.
That, little sister, is not news.
Well, the trouble was, I was in love with Chase, who didn't love me. Now that I'm back, it's all out in the open since Alec found out about Chase and me. Except it doesn't matter anymore because I don't love anybody.
Could you say that by me one more time?
It's simple.
Wait a minute. Who did what to who? You tell me. You give me the word and I'll go after both of them.
I appreciate your brotherly protection, but the Kendall twins are no longer my concern.
You're sure?
I'm sure. Besides, how would it look to Lloyd Kendall, your employer, if you beat his sons to a bloody pulp?
Well, I wasn't really going to take drastic measures. A little arm twisting, maybe.
Thank you, brother dear, but I can take care of myself.
You can. You know, you've changed.
Not that I don't need my big brother.
Oh, thank you very much. You know, I was kind of feeling a little useless here.
Susie's the one who needs you now.
Yeah. She and Jonah. And I love him for it.
She's a lucky girl.
I want her to have everything.
And she will. You've changed, too. You're stronger. The McCleary strength, you have it. It comes through every time.
I know it's going to work out. And I know that Susie's going to be cleared. The hard thing is, how do I convince Susie?
Justine, hi. Nice surprise. Come in.
Hello, Wendy.
Hi.
I guess you must have heard the news.
Couldn't miss it. It's on every channel.
Yeah, well, you ain't seen nothing yet.
I'd say you gave quite a performance for the grand jury.
Well, that's just the beginning. Before I am through, there won't be a person in this town who doesn't believe that Susie is a cold-blooded murderer.
So you're going to go all the way?
Right up to slamming the prison door in her face. Can I get you some wine? Celebrate? I know just a toast, too. To Susie Wyatt. May she rot in jail.
I can't drink to that.
Why? There's no capital punishment in this town. Let me see. Bottle of wine. Gotta be around here somewhere. Here we go.
I came here to ask you to back down.
Come on. You hate Susie as much as I do.
Hate's a waste of time.
All I have right now.
You must have loved him very, very much.
I did. He was everything to me. When he died, I wanted to die too.
But you didn't. You're here. You're alive. Now you want to throw your life away?
I'm not throwing it away. I'm dedicating it to Warren. I'm doing exactly what he would have wanted me to do. I'm going to protect his child, and I'm going to make Susie pay.
Like the poet said, revenge is sweet. The one thing he forgot to add is that it's as much a waste of time as hate is.
A sermon from you?
Susie and Cagney have been through enough. Why don't you just let them get on with their lives?
Why should I? They finished mine.
What do you hope to gain?
Justice.
Oh, come off it. You want that baby. You've admitted it. Even if you hounded Susie into a prison sentence, you're still not going to get that baby. Susie and Cagney won't let you near him.
You are still in love with him. You know you really are something. Susie killed my husband. She almost killed you. She has the baby, the man you love. You should be helping me, not pleading her case. You came here to ask me to beg. Did you really love him that much? You'd let her step all over you?
I'm not asking you to stop for Cagney. I'm asking for your sake, too.
Oh, please. Don't do me any favors, all right?
I understand how you feel. I just don't want to see you fall into the same trap I did. Yes, I wanted to ruin Susie's life, and all I did was mess up mine. Please stop, Wendy, now, before anybody else gets hurt.
I'll stop. I'll tell you when I'll stop. I'll stop when that baby is mine and she is behind bars.
Have you heard one word I said?
Susie killed a kind, wonderful, innocent man, and she is not going to get away with it.
You don't really believe he was innocent.
With all my heart.
He was a criminal. He was serving a sentence.
How dare you! You don't know him. Nobody knows him like I do. the real Ward Carter, his loves, his dreams. I will never abandon him. And I will never abandon his child.
I was in a dream, too. I said something about sharing and that we should all get together.
Well, I'm sorry if it upset you, sweetheart.
Well, no, it didn't really. Not as much as the nightmares I used to have about Lloyd.
That's good. That's a step in the right direction.
I do like him a little bit better than I used to. But still, the thought of being a Kendall...
Does that frighten you?
A little.
Well, you know what? Chase and Alec are Kendalls.
I know, but I've liked them for a long time.
Well, everyone in a family is different. That's what makes each family special.
The Centels are special.
And the Kendalls are special, too. You should ask Lloyd about the family history.
Well, we talked a little bit about it at the dinner party last week. He said that I was named after his mother and that Rebecca meant unity.
Well, that's nice. You know what? I bet he would love to share more of the family history with you. I talked a little bit about that tonight to my board of directors. About the Turner family history, what it means to T.I. I had the privilege of knowing the general. Well, that's a character. And then he passed things on to Travis. And someday that will be Turner's and yours. But you know what, sweetheart? The only way to build on your heritage is really to look back and understand the goals, the aspirations of the people who came before you.
I never knew anything about the Turners.
Well, now, we can certainly change that. Because it's all in the Turner diary is right here. And here, and here, and here, and here.
I'd like to read them sometime.
Good, good, I hope so. I'd like you to. It's a little late to get started tonight, but I do want you to look at them sometime.
Well, I bet they couldn't tell me anything else besides what I already know about my mother. That she is the best mother in the whole world.
That's easy. I got the best daughter.
I'm never gonna leave you. Never.
No.
And I don't want you to ever leave me.
That's not gonna happen, darling. I'm gonna stay right here with you.
I never want anything bad to happen to you.
Nothing's going to happen to me. I promise.
What's in a name? Liza Centel.
Thank you.